Hey there, I'm the real Jason Duncan, and we're going to get emotional today. I want to tell you about something called emotional impact. We're in a six-part series on the six steps to success in selling. It's based around the idea of the Challenger Sale book that came out in the mid-2000s by Matthew Dixon and Brett Adamson. And it's a wonderful book that talks about how the Challenger rep outperforms every other rep 2-1. And there are certain things that the Challenger rep does that makes him or her so much more successful than all the other people out there, like the relationship builders or the reactive problem solver, the hard worker, the lone wolf. Those guys do not perform as well as you as a challenger rep. And I'm going to give you these six steps. I'm a former school teacher, and I understand that people learn visually, kinesthetically, and auditorily. There are three ways they learn. So whatever way that you learn, I'm going to make sure that you have enough information that you can remember all six of these steps in order. And by the way, I want to interject right here that I do professional sales coaching for sales teams. So if you have a sales team that you want to perform at a higher level to close more deals so that you can make more money, I would be honored to talk to you about how I can engage with you and your sales team. I've got one particular sales team that I've been working with this year. They're up 43% in their revenue because of some of the things that I've been teaching them. So I want to work with you too. So if you want to find out how to get in touch with me, go to therealjasonduncan.com and go to the contact page and just reach out and say, hey, I saw your Friday sales tip video. I would like to talk to you about that. We could set up a 20-minute compatibility call, just you and me. We could talk about what it is that your company needs and how I can help you meet those needs and take you to the next level. I'm the real Jason Duncan on Instagram, on LinkedIn, and on YouTube. Make sure you follow me at one or all of those places. So visually, auditorily, kinesthetically, we're going to go through these six steps. The first step, here's the image. So the image is going to be here for visual learners. And then kinesthetically, this is the image. And what is that? That's the warmer. That's right, it's the warmer. Step two, you see the image and you see my fingers. See the image there and my fingers? That's the reframe, that's right. Step three, there's the image. See the little brain there? And then what that means, if I put my three fingers above my head, above my brain, it looks like I'm drowning. Remember the old Bugs Bunny cartoon? If you haven't watched video three, go back and watch that. That's rational drowning. It's about the numbers, it's about all the things. Well, today we're talking about emotional impact. You see the image right here? It's the little theater faces. You know, one's happy, one's sad. Those are emotions. And the theater is about emotions. It's about contriving those emotions for theater, for theatrical purposes. But emotions are very important in the sales process. And admittedly, this is the part of sales that I suck at the most. If you look at female salespeople, they outperform male salespeople on the emotional connection better than anybody, because females are more emotional, generally speaking, than males are. I actually suck at this, but I understand that I suck at it. And so I work hard to overcome this. But this idea of emotional impact has to begin with this concept. And I'll give you the kinesthetic way to remember it in just a minute. We've got the little two images, the happy and the sad face for the theater. I'll tell you what that means in a minute, but just remember their emotions. But emotions drive decisions and logic backs it up. So every decision you've ever made has been an emotion, to buy something has been an emotional decision. There's an emotional connection to a shirt, to a house, to a piece of jewelry, to something for your car. You know, whatever it is, there's an emotional connection, and then you justify it with logic. So what a challenger sales rep does is they do the warmer, which lets the prospect know that he or she is, you are to the prospect, that absolute professional expert who knows how to solve their problem. Step two is the reframe. You're reframing the conversation around what you're actually going to talk about, not just specifically the product or service. Step three is the rational drowning. You go over all the numbers and then how the, you know, the logical reason why you want that, why the prospect wants to do this. Well, now in step four is you actually want to dive into the emotional reasons of why the prospect should do whatever it is that you're wanting them to buy to do. Now, the kinesthetic way to remember this is, there's the thing called the clapper, and I'm not talking about that thing on TV where you clap your finger, you clap your hands and the lights turn off. What I'm talking about is in theater and in movies and on television, they have, if they're filming it, they have this little board and it writes the scene numbers, and then at the top it has a little clapper that goes like this, and it claps to say, and action. Well, I want you to use your four fingers to pretend to be one of those clapper boards and just lift up that top finger. And I know, again, this sounds silly and you're like, this is the dumbest thing. And if you're out in public listening to this, watching this video, you know, if somebody see you doing this, they're gonna think you're crazy. But I promise you, this is a way to remember it. And remembering it is really important, because as a salesperson, when you're out in the field and you're trying to think, well, why did that sales call not go well? Did I do the warmer? Did I do the reframe? Did I do the rational journey? Did I do the emotional impact? This will help you remember those things, because you're not, your memory is not as good as you think that it is. So this idea of emotional impact is where you're going to talk about the emotional reasons why, personally, why this person wants to do business and should do business with you. Or maybe not specifically with you, because you haven't talked about yourself yet, you're gonna talk about your solution later, but about why they need the solution. Why they need the solution, that there's a problem that they need to have solved. Well, one of my businesses, I sell LED lighting retrofits. And one of the emotional reasons for that is that, hey, if you as the CFO get your compensation is based on profitability for the hospital or for the business that you are the CFO of, then how much better would that make your family feel if you were able to take home a larger bonus this year because you saved the company 90% on their electrical fees? Or what if you're selling swimming pools or landscape, hardscapes? Well, if you do that, I mean, the emotional tie is great. You're not selling the hole in the ground with water in it. You're selling, hey, think about how much time you're gonna get to spend with your kids and your grandkids out in the pool. There's an emotional impact that you've gotta tie into. That's what step four is in the six steps to success in selling. You've got to figure out what that emotional impact is for the thing that you're selling. Remember, it's not the product, it's not the service itself, it's the preferred future. It's the thing that's gonna happen in the future because they purchased the product or service that you're selling. So as a professional salesperson, as a challenger, you gotta take control of the process, you gotta make sure that you warm them up, then make sure that you do the reframe, make sure that you do all the numbers, the rational drowning, and then at this stage in the game, you need to make sure that you do, or if you just use your four fingers, you're doing the emotional impact. Remember, this is the theater clapper. Those are the theater images with the happy and the sad, the emotions. You're going to do an emotional impact. Now, I want you to pay attention to something. You've been watching this video series. This is the fourth one. You've watched them all. Thank you for doing that. What you've noticed is that I have not yet talked about myself yet. I haven't talked about my company. I haven't talked about my solution. That shows up in the next two steps. So make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel, because we're going to be going over these next two steps over the next 2 weeks. So make sure you go to therealjasonduncan.com. You can find me there. You can find me on Instagram or LinkedIn or YouTube at therealjasonduncan. And I'll be happy to help you get to close more deals and make more money, because that's what this is about. And remember, if you're interested in bringing me in to coach your sales team, I'd be honored to talk to you about that. I don't have room, but I only got room right now as I'm recording this video. I only have room for one more sales team to coach just to fit it into my schedule. But you might be that company who needs that sales coaching. So reach out to me through therealjasonduncan.com. It'll be the first link in the description below. Thank you for being here. Make sure you subscribe, hit the bell icon, and I will see you next Friday when I go over step five and the six steps to success in selling. Until then, remember, Jesus is King.